Greetings, minions. I am your humble narrator, Sideways Thinker. And I'm just here with a brand new Let's Play. This time it's of Shadowrun Returns. This is a lie. This is a lie. This is a lie. Shadowrun Returns on that there PC. I do not know why Shadowrun Returns says Shadowrun Dragonfall. Because it does have Dead Man's Switch in it. Which is Shadowrun Returns. I don't know why it's... I kind of guess why, but it's still, it's fucking weird. But yes, Shadowrun Returns. For those of you who don't know what Shadowrun Returns is, it is the first in the, I suppose, kind of revamped series of Shadowrun CRPGs that's kind of a follow-on from, I believe it was like the SNES Shadowrun game. It was funded on Kickstarter. I didn't fund it on Kickstarter, because I don't fund shit on Kickstarter. And I was kind of vaguely interested in it, because I'm sure some of you know that I'm quite fond of the Shadowrun setting. Shadowrun 4th edition is probably the most fun I've had in a tabletop RPG when I played that campaign. The campaign specifically that was run by my good friend Type. Odd thing about that, actually, he recently told me that if I ever brought a character to a game he runs, like the character I brought to that Shadowrun game, he will, he'll end me. Because my character was the most DM, or GM, antagonizing character I think I've ever made. It's fun, though. But, yeah, no, it's an action it's a CRPG, not an action RPG, turn-based CRPG, based on Shadowrun, developed by Harebrained Schemes. This is actually the first of three Shadowrun RPGs. And as much as I really enjoyed Shadowrun Returns, it's actually my least favorite of the three. My favorite of the three is Shadowrun Dragonfall, with Hong Kong being a close second. Now, the reason it's saying Dragonfall here is because originally, Dragonfall was a DLC for Shadowrun Returns. It then later got released as its own game with new content and just a better system. And honestly, it's just better than Shadowrun Returns as a Shadowrun game. We are going to play Shadowrun Returns, though. It's entirely possible that we may very well end up playing... Just going to put my phone on Do Not Disturb here. It is entirely possible that I may end up doing Let's Plays of Dragonfall and Hong Kong, because as I say, I do prefer those games. But figured, if we're going to start at the first one, Shadowrun Returns. Plus, it's been a long time since I've even looked at Shadowrun Returns. I've played Dragonfall like two or three times, Hong Kong once, but that was relatively recently. Shadowrun Returns, I only played it once and then never went back to it. So, let's play Shadowrun Returns, which is the Dead Man's Switch campaign, not Shadowrun Dragonfall. And in we go. Now, I've actually been hoping or intending to do this series for a very long time. But the reason I avoided it is because the game has no voice acting. And I didn't want to read everything. Now, I will read shit. I am going to read almost everything out. At least I'm going to try to. I may give up. But I am not necessarily going to be doing fucking voice acting for everything. I'm not going to do a silly voice for every character. Maybe for a couple. But simply because the reason, because this is a fucking RPG and we'd be here all day. You know what I mean? You know, we'd never get anywhere. Okay. Character creation. I'm kind of excited. Like, it's weird. Like, I've went through a period, I'm not sure if I mention it on the channel all that often, but I go through periods of being unsure as to what I want to record, and this will last for, like, weeks, and then suddenly I'm just like, ah! That! And then I have a series. And for some reason it just occurred to me, I was like, oh, I've got nothing to record. Hey, Shadowrun! So here we go. We can pick from various races. You can see here that the races have effects on the stats. Humans have more karma, which is essentially your XP. They just start normal across the board. Elves are a bit quicker and more charismatic. All dwarves. Yeah, that's like the maximum there. So yeah, they're more charismatic. Dwarves have got more willpower. Orcs are just stronger, and trolls are just massive. I never play as trolls. What I think I'm gonna do is I'm gonna play as kind of a sneaky character, maybe, I don't know. So we're gonna play as a dwarf. Now we have archetypes. if you are comfortable with the way characters are built in Shadow, and you may create your own character. I don't like doing that. I like going one of the pre-decided ones. So what should we go with here? I'm going to tell you this right now. Not being a Fizz Adept. Fuck Fizz Adepts. Or a Shaman. Or a Mage. I don't like magic in this game. Or in Shadowrun in general. I'm not a big fan of magic. It's weird, because Shadowrun, if you don't know anything about the setting, Shadowrun's thing is that at some point, I think around 2020, there's a thing called the Awakening, in which magic appeared. So there's like dragons and spirits and demons and shit like that all over the place. And humans start turning into meta-humans, like the elves and the dwarves. And then you had the goblinization, in which people turned into orcs and trolls. They're still human, and I believe a lot of them are born human and then turn into these things as they get older. I think that's still the case with orcs and trolls, is that you are... I think unless you're born to orcs and trolls, you can be born human and then just turn into an orc or a troll quite violently during puberty, to the point at which I think it kills a lot of people. And that's really cool. Like, it's this fusion of magic and dystopian sci-fi. This dystopian sci-fi cyberpunk setting. Personally, I lean a lot further towards the cyberpunk. I tend to be a street samurai. We could be a decker who are hackers, or a rigger. You know, I think I'm actually going to be a decker. Purely because, even though it's not a good idea to be, it's not necessarily a good plan to be a dwarf decker, but purely because deckers hack things, and the hacking in this game... The thing is, the hacking in this game is really boring and shit. Because it's basically just like... You're basically just going through a normal area, except there's only one of you. But if you don't, you have to like hire in other deckers. I don't know. You know what? Fuck it. I'm going to be a street samurai. We've got various little pictures here, which will actually auto-generate our little character down here. It's actually one thing, is that in Shadowrun Hong Kong, they actually updated the models. Because the models in this, if I go through the various different races, are pretty silly and cartoony, but the models in Hong Kong are a lot cooler, they're a lot slicker. I would normally play an orc, is the thing. I tended to play orcs. Because I just like orcs. Do you know what I mean? Because they're just kind of cool. Should I just play an orc? I suppose I'm playing a street samurai, so... Yeah, I think I'll play an orc. What skin should I use for the orc? You know what? Yeah, do that. Change your skin color, though. Although, maybe a troll? I don't know, I'm planning on using ranged. Nah, I'll stick with a dwarf. Stick with a dwarf, go with this portrait. And... his beard. Is there any better looking beards than that? No, wait, hang on. Oh, if only I could put in a custom portrait, I could make me. Ah, well, we'll go with that. It doesn't really matter that much. Okay, confirm. No, continue to stats, rather. Okay. Spend our karma. We start with some karma. Karma, chameleon. I like shotguns. So let's go with shotguns. Let's also plop that in there. Plop that in the shotgun as well. And then later on, we will almost certainly be putting points in charisma. Just so we can be better at chatting to people. Confirm. Ah, and we get to pick an etiquette, which is basically just it's a way to dodge certain charisma checks if you know an etiquette. We're gonna go with gang. Let's go with a gang etiquette. And name the character. Because isn't it always? Whenever I play a dwarf, that dwarf must be Logan Eight Fingers. If you don't know who Logan Eight Fingers is, well, he's from an old D&D game, The Sinister Secrets of Ironwood. It's on the channel, the whole game, every session's recorded. Go search it, Sinister Secrets of Ironwood. It was a fun game. Ended badly. Group drama caused some problems. Yes, indeed. Oh, right, I should probably read this. Down and out. Your apartment, 3 o'clock in the morning. It's got 4 walls, a roof, and isn't on fire. Even the cockroaches have fled in search of better accommodations. Not exactly a runner's dream pad, but right now, it's about all you have left. Running the shadows is all about feast or famine. One day you're Nova Hot, working... Yeah, we're gonna be... Get ready for weird phrasing. Working jobs that allow you to eat at 5-star restaurants. The next? Well, you're here. This one's a famine for the ages. Slagging fixer hasn't called. The money's run out and then some. Sinless and free. Free to starve in the cracks of a society run by mega corporations who just want your new yen. New yen being the money. Something needs to change. And soon. Yes, there's a lot of odd phrasing goes on in this game. Okay, that's... What have we got here? Slip of paper with your bank balance, enough to cover you through the end of the week. So this is actually very much in resemblance of the life that you get in Shadowrun when you play the tabletop game. Shadowrunners, if you don't know what Shadowrunners are, they're essentially alarmingly, surprisingly hardcore, like, black market mercenaries. You know, they do jobs for criminals, they do jobs for corporations, they basically will do a job for anyone that can pay. The game kind of expects you to be almost kind of Robin Hood types, and that you're criminals with a heart of gold. Perhaps Robin Hood is the best example, like Han Solo, like in terms of personality, but not necessarily. But yeah, you're kind of the best people in a shitty world, is essentially your job. And you are, and when I say like Black Ops, black market mercenaries, I mean like Black Ops. Like, you guys are like ridiculously elite given your situation. Like, it's just these anomalously skilled people. I suppose it's like the same conceit as adventurers and basically any other RPG. It's like, yeah, there's just this anomalously skilled group of people who just wander around and just do shit. Your notebook, calendar contacts, that kind of thing. You're the contacts. The list is sad, dried up. Carter, Detroit, fixer, no response to messages. Dowd, runner, dead. Dowd? Dowd. Why do I know the name Dowd? Ah, I remember the name Dowd. That annoys me. Felton Nash, fixer, missing since February. New Larry, runner, dead. Sam Watts, runner, probably in a gutter somewhere. Sangoma, runner, dead. Halfjack, dealer, retired or dead. I don't know, I feel like Halfjack might be a reference to the books. I don't know if, maybe all of these are references to the books. In the actual books for the Shadowrun RPG, they have characters posting essentially on kind of a board, like a chat room board, commenting about shit relevant to what's on the page. And there's like a long series of characters that exist throughout most of the books. And I think Halfjack, it's either Halfjack or Fastjack is one of them. One of the best examples of that actually was in, I can't remember which version of Shadowrun it was for, but the Renraku Arcology book. Because they actually played out a story of this chat room being essentially invaded by weird shit. It's like, you know, in the margins of the book. It's pretty cool. View my personal calendar. It's empty. Nothing to do. Good! Put the notebook down. Yes, my vidphone's ringing, but I'm going to go check my computer first. Your computer, state in the art in 2050, broken since, wait, is that broken in 2051? Broken since 2051, okay. Sam Watts, the screen leaps to life, making you squint against its brightness. The face on the screen is laughing. Sam Watts. Hey buddy, hope I didn't catch you at a bad time. He giggles. He's drunk again, or worse. Shouldn't have given you my com code, gonk. Gonk. I don't even know what that means. I'm guessing it is an insult. Another giggle. Oh, don't bother with your side of the conversation. I'm not really here. Just one reason for this vid. Someone finally geeked me. I'm dead. I probably had it coming. You look like the kind of guy who probably had it coming. when you're an unsavory character like myself, you tend to associate with other unsavory characters, often partake in unsavory business. Like you, for example. So, why am I dead? Who knows? Probably my fault. Probably the fault of your fucking hair. I wonder where you are right now. I bet you hit a big payday and you're living high on the hog somewhere. Some of us are born winners, and some of us are me. Yep. Living it high! Hey, remember that Runraku run when things went to hell and we lost Dowd? I recognize the name Dowd from somewhere. Dishonored. It's spelt differently. D-A-U-D. That's where I remember Dowd from. It's probably almost certainly not a reference, because Dishonored may very well have come out after this. Don't know. And it's spelt differently. Oh, that makeshift saloon on the docks afterwards? I really had your back that night, didn't I? Dowd, that's a name you haven't heard in a long time. Oh, we're getting a flashback. Oh! Sorry. 3 years ago, a makeshift bar in the Seattle docks. The night Dowd went down. New Larry. I don't know. Look at this smarmy cunt! Doesn't he look like a prick? He's been running with New Larry for about 6 months now. He's a combat mage with a bad tattoo and a bad attitude. If that's the tattoo, that is a bad tattoo. He knew Dowd almost as well as you did. Dowd, never saw anyone who died like that before. Idiot. Wait, do we not get to see Dowd? Dowd's already dead, so we don't get to... Okay. He shakes his head. I hate this fragging city, Logan Eight Fingers. It's wet and the rain feels like acid, and I want out of here. We wait for the money. Yeah, sure, of course. I'll wait all night if I have to. Yeah, you fucking will. We need money. We need Nguyen. It's the It's the weird thing about Shadowrun is that... It's like one of the few It's one of the few tabletop RPGs where the game expects you to be in it purely for the cash. It's kind of impressive. I don't know, Logan Eight Fingers. Sam is a good guy and can hold his own in a fight, but he's been hitting the bottle pretty good lately. Never on a run so far, but he needs watching. He shakes his head. That run went sideways. That run went sideways 9 ways to Sunday. Now the fixer is late. That bastard better show. We need the money. I want to get paid as much as you do, buddy, but we need to live long enough to actually drink the Nguyen we earn. Cut the dreck. Sam, we both know why Dowd went down, and it wasn't the fixer, some other paranoid chip dream of yours. Sam smiles a toothy smile. I've been waiting for this all night. New Larry has something he wants to say, don't you, Larry? Go ahead. Spill it. You were sloppy. Sloppy? You think I was sloppy? You've been twitchy all day, son. Look at your hands. They're shaking. Own up, Sam. If you screwed up, admit it. I'd admit it if there was something to admit. I was on point. New Larry was supposed to cover Dowd. Something dawns on him. He leans into New Larry, amused and dangerous. We were set up, and he knows it, don't you, Larry? What was that call you made before we hit Runraku? By the way, Runraku... just for some reason, I've never been able to figure out why, but I like Runraku. I think it's just because I really like the Runraku Arcology book. Never played that adventure, but I like the book. How come you couldn't geek that guy before you unloaded on Dowd? I've seen you fling a lightning bolt, son. He should have been burnt toast before his gun cleared the holster. New Larry checks his watch, licks his lips, looks over your shoulder with the darkness. He's looking for someone, and it's not the fixer. Okay, I can see where this is going. Your chummers are damaged. I'm out. Hands where I can see him, dick fuck! He stops and the smile slowly appears in his face. What, you're gonna take my gun away, Logan Eight Fingers? You know I don't need one. Look at the teeth on that. Okay. Sorry, I didn't actually read the dialogue. Looks like my new Runraku friends are finally here. They're gonna take the heart off your corpse, buddy. We should choose our friends more carefully, Logan. That guy was never my friend. Mine either. I think I'll shoot him. Yeah. Although, I don't know, maybe... Okay, did the game actually give me a shotgun? Ow, you bastard. To this point, I'm like just desperately hoping I remember how this game works in terms of its cover system. I don't need a tutorial. Does -1 AP. Okay, I don't really think I need armor piercing on this guy because he's a wizard, so I'll just... Oh, critted him at close range. Lovely. Just probably get this guy behind a wall as well. Right, go down. is she? What are you? Well, she can summon a thing, so I'm guessing that she's a shaman of some description. Because yes, shaman can summon, like, elemental creatures, which is quite entertaining. Because it basically allows you to summon extra squad members. There is always a danger when shaman summon spirits, though. Fuck you, buddy. That danger being that... that danger being that they can, go... They can go rogue, is the problem. I'm not sure we need it right now. And yeah, you saw that I had an escape chance based on how many action points we gave it. Oh, okay, they're coming from that direction. This is... Well, actually, no, this is fun. Right. You big burly bastard. Fucking one-hit KO. I like it. I approve. One-hit KO and you fucking missed. And oh god, they're coming from everywhere! Is there like an Overwatch that I can do? Probably not. Get you behind cover as well, madam. Let's give him 3 AP and hope he doesn't escape. Cool, he didn't escape. Right, let's just fucking... You can kill them when you don't have any use for them, which is good. The weird thing is that it makes sense that you need to have an escape chance on these things, because those spirits at times can be really... They can be massive boons. Do you know what I mean? Oh shit. Reloading! Skadoosh! Okay, that did not go well. Yeah, it's not so good being a shaman when, that is actually also the thing, is that at least when you're fighting them, in my experience, it tends to be a better idea to go for the, shaman rather than what they summon, for the simple reason that the shaman is almost certainly going to be easier to kill. And this shaman, didn't pay attention to that particular lesson. Oh, awesome, you're not in cover! And now you're a dead person. Oh, shit. Reloading. How about you? Lovely. And there, because combat's over, the spirit just vanishes on its own. And we got some health back, which is good. Sangoma lowers her gun. Eyes Sam. You okay, Sam? Sam's breathing is heavy and he looks shaken. That was a hell of a thing. Part of the life, Sam, you know that. You were born for this gig, Logan. Me? Not so much. I think I'm gonna hang it up, find a nice brothel somewhere, stay drunk till I croak. What about you? Me? I do this. It's the only life I know. Well, you're a dumbass and I'll drink to you when you're dead. Who am I kidding? I'm not gonna outlast you. Guess you can drink to me. Yeah, you're not gonna outlast me. Case in point, this is a flashback caused by the fact that you're currently a corpse, my friend. Then again, I suppose what's the point of arguing with a flashback? Know what I mean? You stare at Sam's face and you comlink. Shake off the memory. Focus. Also, that wouldn't be on his comlink. A comlink's like a small phone. It's like clearly like a fucking Skype machine he's got set up. I had you back that night, didn't I? Now I'm asking myself, who would care if I die? Who'd give a rat's ass? Better or worse, your name is at the top of that list. Maybe it's the only name on the list. So set up a dead man switch to send you this call. Hence the name of the campaign. I got 100,000 New Yen insurance policy payable when you find who creased me. Alive, with a conviction, or in a body bag with justification. Either works. Contact my law firm, Rogers, Mengett and McCain. John McCain? He survived to 25th! Oh, fucking, no, sorry, it's a terrible joke. When the job is done, they'll know. For all I know, he might be dead. They'll know what to do. Chance was left. Chet? God, you look smarmy. The camera swivels to show a well-dressed man sitting next to Sam. Pursuant? I'm assuming that's pursuant. I can't think of any other way to pronounce that. Pursuant to Mr. Watt's wishes, Rogers, Mengert, and McCain has installed a secure, dedicated phone line so you may contact us directly when the task is complete. We will then begin a verification process. Note that you must also be on a secure landline to access this number. We will not accept transmissions from comlinks or other devices. Sam straightens up. Talks seriously. First time. Look, Logan, I've led a dreck life, and I probably left a dreck corpse. I've hurt people. Hurt myself. I don't know. Maybe I just want the last word. Maybe I just want someone to give a crap that I sucked air for a while. What do you say? I'd say my schedule's pretty clear right now. Hope you just said yes. Well, the game didn't give me an option, so... technically, get a job, any job. I've got a locator chip slotted in my head these days. If, when my heart stops, it'll activate. That's how you'll find me. See you on the slab. Guess I'm heading back to Seattle. Because Seattle is, I believe, just generally the main setting for Shadowrun. There are other settings, but typically everything happens in Seattle. Your plane hits the SeaTac tarmac with a jolt. Welcome to Seattle. The chilly northwest rain obscures your vision as you step onto the tarmac. Before long, you're sitting in the cramped backseat of a cab, following the signal from Sam's locator chip into the heart of the Redmond Barrens. Organ grinders. A legal chop shop for body parts. Whether from the living or the dead. If you're hurting bad enough for New Yen, this is the place to sell a limb or an organ. It's also a good place to dispose of an inconvenient body while making a little cash on the side. This franchise is the closest thing the Barrens has to a morgue. It seems this is where Sam Watts' body ended up. You open the door and are assaulted by the smell of death and bleach. And at this point, I believe we shall end it for this video. I'm quite looking forward to this series, but that's going to have to be all for me for now. I've been your humble knight, Sardis Thinker, and as always, keep calm and carry on. Good day. Well, I hope you enjoyed this video as much as I enjoyed making it. Well, I say that, I could have been having a terrible day when I made this video. You can't tell, and I certainly can't. Pre-recorded message and all that. All the same, if you're interested in seeing some live streaming stuff from me, if you look in the description, there'll be a link to my Twitch page, as well as a link to my Twitter in case you want to keep up with all the random gibberish I spew throughout the week. And if you're feeling particularly generous, you can always donate to my Patreon campaign, also linked in the description. Well, that's all from me. This video's over. Leave. Now. Now!
Do not seek the Sideways Thinker. Do not seek the Pardoner.